Casper device has high output impedance, making the current mirror acting as an ideal current source. Hi, my name is Mohammad Hashim Chaudhary. I have completed my master's from Jamia Millia Islamia, which is a Delhi-based central university. And currently, I am a trainee in ASIC batch in Pine Training Academy. I have worked on multiple projects in Pine and learned a lot of things. Let me show you how Casper current mirror works on Cadence 2. Matches can be summarized into three categories, in which first one is process variation, second one is threshold voltage variation, and the VDS variation. To reduce the VDS variation, as a designer can choose longer length for the device, but it is not good practice. Another technique is to implement a Casper current mirror. By having a Casper current mirror, VDS of Q2 should be matched with VDS of Q1. So the current mirror will significantly reduce the VDS difference between Q2 and Q1. If D2 will try to increase by I drive increases, the VDS of Q4 will reduce the limiting current that Q2 is trying to increase. This way, I drive will be kept very close to I reference in a small feedback loop. The advantage of Casper current mirror eliminates the channel length modulation by keeping VDS 1 and VDS 2. I out equal to I reference WYL 1 plus lambda VDS 2 divided by WYL 1 plus lambda VDS 1 to make VDS 1 equal to VDS 2, so that's I out equal to I reference. Second one advantage of the Casper current mirror: improves output resistance to become GM4, RO4, RO2. This is a Casper current mirror, this is a I reference, and this is a I drive. To making the topology of Casper current mirror by using this. This is one current mirror, this is another current mirror. This current mirror provide the VGS3 equal to VGS4, and this VGS4 should be matched the VDS2 equal to the VDS1. So that we provide the input shielding of the reference current, and it becomes independent of the load also. And this current is ID equal to 9.99, should be matched to the 9.99865. In our circuit NM1, this transistor VDS equal to 475.842 millivolt, and this transistor NM2 equal to VDS equal to 475.658 millivolt. This is almost close to each other. So that's why the reference current should be equal to drive current. So this is the ideal current source behavior shows by using Casper current mirror topology. We want to analyze this circuit on Cadence Virtuoso 2. Go to the launch button and click on launch. Then go to the ADL. Then open the ADL window. Then select the analysis as DC analysis to select the DC point, and save DC operating points to tick the DC operating points and click on OK. Then run the circuitry. Then close it. Go to the results and go to the print. Then select as a DC operating points. Then right click on mouse to annotation and go to the DC operating points. This DC operating point shows on the terminal. This is the ID. This is 9.9 because we have taken as a reference current 10 microampere. So we go to the annotation and select as setup to choose cell as NMOS 1 and DC operating points. We have also add one more region to select region and then press OK. This region shows all the transistors should be in saturation region. So region 2 shows this is the saturation region. So all the transistors in saturation region. If you have any suggestions, please comment below.